Put your hands together for ACHG Production. Hey.
We're ready.
We're ready.
Good afternoon, ACHG Production. Reaching for the doggone sky. Just getting ready to have a good time. In the night time. Are you ready? Mama, sister, brother.
Hi, and welcome to AC Fun Time Superstar. My name is AC, and my co-host is
Elder Curly Town.
I'd like to tell you, we've got a dynamite show lined up for you today. Want to holler out one time to Cardell Chisholm Jr. from Watermelon Island. Charles, working at Southern Railroad, also from Watermelon Island. Wait a minute, Mac Drayton. Baby Boomer from Burke High School. Driver's Ed. Hey, shout out!
Yeah. Also, I want to give a shout out to Lisa Wineglass Smalls, Tyrell Johnson, and also the Mary Ford alumni, yeah!
We've got a really exciting show lined up for you today. We've got a whole lot of castor oil, and we got some good honey. Now, that honey is entertainment.
And the castor oil, that's about our history and our community. Yeti that.
If you know someone that didn't get a chance to see the show today, tell them to go to www.tifm.wsno.com. Scroll down to the bottom of the page, click on ACHG, Production 1, and you'll be able to see the entire show. Now, in the body where it says, sound off, you'll have an opportunity right there to tell us what you want to...
Tell us what you want to see. Tell us what songs you would like to hear. Tell us what you want to know about our community. Yeah, leave us a comment.
We're going to have a good time up in here today. Right now, for the second time on AC Fun Time, is Landstar! Let's hear it for Landstar.
The Most High provides us with these things. Guidance and protection. He gives us power cause He is the King. Every day we wake up to see a brighter day.
Brighter day.
We go to work and we work hard to make a better way.
Better way.
Giving thanks and praises to the Kings of Kings, Lord of Lords. Never stop praising Him, cause He keeps us strong right here in Babylon.
Guidance and protection, the Most High revives us with these things. Guidance and protection, He gives us power cause He is the King.
People around us have to catch a positive vibe.
Positive vibe.
The Most High is with us to purify our lives.
Purify our lives.
Giving thanks and praises to the Kings of Kings, Lord of Lords. The power is in us. God will always provide
guidance and protection. The Most High revives us with these things. Guidance and protection. He gives us power cause He is the King.
Whoa, yeah. Whoa, now. Na 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 na. Whoa, yeah. Every day we wake up to see a brighter day.
Brighter day.
We go to work and we work hard to make a better way.
And now it's time for a little more castor oil as we continue to speak with Leonard Riley, as we use for an example the hospital nurses strike. Now, we're not talking so much about the strike back in the 60s because we're dealing with issues now that we need to do some things about. Let's talk, see what we can do about the changes we need to make in today's life. Let's talk.
What a perfect setting. Mm. The 45th anniversary of the strike, the hospital strike, where the same issues in 1969 that forced people into the street, that made them say enough is enough, we've got to go on the street, has us here today commemorating those brave people and putting a spotlight on the continued efforts to suppress workers' rights.
You know what I'm hearing?
That's why we're here today.
You know what I'm hearing? I'm hearing from you that God is love.
God is love.
And I'm hearing from you that the Spirit of God is in you. And it reaches out to these people that's being oppressed.
Well, exactly. I agree with you. And
that's what I hear.
It's my mission, and I think the mission of all people that see injustice and want to come to the rescue, I see them as the hand of God working in the human affairs.
All right.
Wow. And that's how I see we fitting in here.
But I got, sometimes you just need, you know how you, in the country you got to prime the pump?
Yes.
Leonard, prime them, say something to get them to understand that we are all in this thing together, and it's God that's leading you in this battle, and they need to come on the battlefield.
What I would say to my church, which is pretty active, and to all church, all churches and believers, more importantly to all believers, is that Christ did all of his work without exception outside the walls of the church. The work of the church is outside, is with the people, is where it's needed to improve the human existence.
Exactly.
So if we think that going to church every Sunday and listening to the message mm-hmm. from the preacher mm-hmm. is all it takes, then we are mistaken.
Oh, right, come on.
Exactly.
We are the bearers of God's word, and that is in action.
Mm.
You know,
exactly.
The good news is that Christ came, Christ died, and Christ is coming again.
Mm.
But that word would not reach the ends of the earth if it's not for us, people like you and I.
Yes.
So let's get out of our comfort zone, get outside the walls of the church, and do the will of God that's in the scriptures.
Mm.
All those Bible stories serve no purpose at all if they don't come off the page of the Bible and be put into action in our struggles in the world today. That's my challenge, and that's my invitation to you all as believers, that we have a mission, and that is to do the will of God that's been handed down to us.
I love it. You know,
I thank you, Leonard. Elder College Town, I know you got some other questions. We spoke about, we talked about it in the
yes,
car.
Yes, yes, yes. I mean, I'm just so excited to be here, and I'm so glad that you said be a doer of the word, because that's really important. But I also, my favorite scripture is, so a man thinketh in his heart, so he is. And I see you, what your heart is. I see your heart, because it's being shown with the work that you're doing. So I appreciate you so much.
Well, thank you.
We don't get a chance to sit us each other. And I want everybody to know that this man is doing a lot of work.
A lot of work.
A lot of work. And we're with you 100%. I wanted to talk to you a little bit about human rights, because that's exactly where you are.
Sure.
We all have a right.
Yeah.
And I see that you have taken those human rights declarations and manifest them in your daily living and helping people. How many people are responding to human rights?
You know, that it's interesting. People want their rights protected. But they don't realize that everybody around them are human beings.
That's true.
And it's part of my mission is to give everybody that space, that position, being human. If we don't talk to one another, then we got all these mitigating things that come in between. When we talk to people, then they become human.
Yes.
If I talk to you,
yes.
I know you're a human being.
Yes.
If I don't talk to John over there, he's sort of dehumanizing. And you know,
wow.
I think we have to talk to each other to really get a respect for each other and know what people. God said we must love one another.
Yes,
you know
exactly.
What I'm saying? And that don't mean I love the bad thing that some people do.
Right.
They might not love some of the things that I do.
Right.
But he said we must love one another.
Exactly.
So if the way I look at that is if God loved that soul that's in that man, I love that soul that's in that man or that woman.
True.
And so in order to work with that situation, we have to communicate, you know, and so my position is that if a person's out there homeless, I shouldn't just walk by them as if they don't count.
Right, exactly.
How's your day?
Yes.
You know, and of course, people are afraid to act because they think they're going to get begged. And somebody's going to ask them for the dollar. There's sometimes just a sense of brotherhood that we should exhibit every time we encounter someone else. Matter of fact, I call that witnessing.
I heard that.
And
because if
something's in here, it's gonna come out here.
Yeah, thank you.
And it's gonna show up in your actions.
Yes.
I heard a pastor talk about this the other day. People start their testimonies of, the Lord, give honor to the Lord who's the center of my life. If he's the center of your life, you don't have to say that that
much. Oh, praise the Lord.
You show it in your natural interaction with people.
Right.
So I'm a firm believer. Let's do what we preach about.
Mm.
You know, because that's the biggest testimony. That's the biggest way to advance, you know, the word of God.
Yes.
And when we talk about human rights and human nature and all of this stuff, I think it's a natural.
It is a natural.
If we're going to be effective witnesses, if we're going to be effective allies for change, for the betterment of human rights, then it has to start with our encounter, every encounter. Either your action is going to substantiate your belief in that principle, or it's going to talk against it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So one way that I try to be consistent in what I believe, and I'm human just like anybody else. Sometimes I'm perplexed by the lack of the collective will to do the right thing.
Come on.
You know, I mean, we have politicians. We have ministers. We have people that say, I believe in this, and I am your representative, and I am this. But I just don't get it when you can be comfortable enough not to act in some of these situations.
Exactly.
So, you know, I applaud the people that are doing a great job, and some of them definitely are.
Mm-hmm.
But I have a concern about the collective will of people that call themselves Christians to address some of these very real problems that we face. Let's get this thing right. You know, instead of sitting back and criticizing that, the gay community, which I believe marriage between a man and a woman. That's the Bible. And they ain't what Atlanta want. It's the Bible. But they have exhibited the ability to focus themselves, to pool their resources, to get the changes that they desire.
Right, exactly.
We should be doing the same thing.
Wow, after that strong dose of castor oil, we need some honey up in here.
Yes, and the first time on AC Funtime Superstar and the Baby Boomers, we have the Mystic Vibration.
Show your love.
Good afternoon. Welcome to AC Funtime Superstar and the Baby Boomers. I'm Arthur Chisholm, and my co-host is Elder Collingtown. How are you feeling today, Elder?
I'm excellent. It's so wonderful to be here tonight. And who we're
visiting with today?
We're visiting with Pastor Dennis.
Listen, it's good to see you guys. I'm glad that you took time out of your busy television schedule to come see a little guy in radio.
No.
Thank you for having me.
Ladies and gents, I am so happy to be in the presence of Mr. Sam Dennis.
Wow.
And most of you know that he is the talk about the town. Sam, we've got a question for you. Elder Collingtown, what would you like to ask Sam so the viewing audience would know who is Sam and what concerns him?
And that's the question I wanted to ask him. Who's Sam Dennis?
Sam is the type of person that wants to be a promoter of people. I've always put myself on the back burner to make sure that other people are exalted, and especially in the community. I want the world to know the talent and the gifts that we have in our community, and especially in the communities that I serve in. I serve as the chairperson of the North Charleston Martin Luther King Committee, and my main aim on that committee is people are always saying that there's crime in our communities, but nobody is coming with the resolve. What is the resolve? What are some of the things that we could do in the committee? So what we do, we go into several committees and we celebrate the community. I learned something from basketball player Magic Johnson. He built several movie theaters and crime-riddled communities. And what he did was he employed the boys from the community. The reason being, those movie theaters are still up today. They're up, they're running, and nobody is bothering them because the community built them. And I believe that that's what we've got to do. We have to continue to build people and by in many ways that I have an opportunity to do it, by ways of the community, my community involvement, by means of radio. This year, the Lord allow, June, I will be in radio broadcast ministry for 33 years. And we just appreciate everything that the community continues to do. And all I want to do is to be able to promote somebody else. If I can take this one match that God has given me and I can strike it and light somebody else's match, and that person light somebody else's match, before you know, we will have illuminated the whole community. I think that's what Sam Dennis is. Make sure you continue to support these folks.
AC Funtime Superstar Arthur Chisholm and Elder Collingtown.
You got to be there.
It's now 6 weeks in a row. It's Touch Band and Show on the AC Funtime Superstar. Enjoy.
I gotta be strong. I gotta hold on. 'Cause it won't be too long. Now the tide is coming in, and I see the waves flowing. It's out there on the ocean. I know my ship is coming in, just past the horizon, and right where the sky is. 'Cause out there on the ocean, I know my ship is coming in. So don't leave me hanging. I've been waiting too long for this moment. My ship has finally come. I will travel to the seven seas.
I would even go.
And I will even go wherever the wind blows me.
I'll do anything.
I'll do anything for my destiny. It's like fighting with gravity, and it's bringing me down. 'Cause if this world is spinning round, then tell me how. It's just so long for you to come around. Now the tide is coming in.
I see the way.
Hey, baby. 'Cause out there on the ocean, I know my ship is coming
just
in.
Just the horizon.
And
right where the sky is.
'Cause out there on the ocean, I know it's coming in. I've been waiting too long for this moment. My ship has finally come. Yeah, yeah.
Elder Can we get the baby boomers to give us just a little more honey up in here?
Yeah, let's get some exercise up in here.
Let's get it working. Let's do it.
Bullet.
The second time today, back is Mystic Band and Show. Reggae, let's do it. Was Mystic Vibration for the second time today on AC Funtime Superstar. If you know someone that did not get to see the show today, tell them to go to www.tifm.ws. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and look for ACHG Production 1. And look here, click on Sound Off, and tell us what you like about the show. Tell us what you like to hear, what you like to see. Tell us what you want us to know. Look here, baby boomers, get ready to do the rumble!
On the board, on the board, on the board. aboard. For this stagecoach is about to move out. It is for everyone that has potential and would love to be a superstar. Yeah, buddy, this stagecoach is leaving for Fun Timesville. And the Lord God is your driver to see that we have a safe trip. AC is your conductor. Come on, everybody.
Headed down to Funsville.
Come on.
Come on, take the ride if you will.
Everybody.
You don't have to worry
the
about
Lord God is your driver.
Just come on and get on board.
Ladies and gentlemen, no tickets will be accepted on this trip. You just sit back and ride. Get ready. Everybody put your hands together right about here. We gonna do a soul clap. Come on, everybody. We gonna ride, we gonna ride, we gonna ride. Soul clap, soul clap. Get ready.
Hit it down to Buzzville.
Ride.
Come on, take the ride if you will.
Sit back.
You don't have to worry
the
about
Lord God is your driver.
Just come on and get on board.
First stop, Columbia, South Carolina. Area. Jetburg, Lansing, Somerville, and the surrounding area. Georgetown, McLennanville, Mount Pleasant, and 41. Look out, next stop, Orindale. And the
look out, meet me in Orindale Saturday at 1 o'clock at the horse race.
Horse race, horse race.
North Charleston, West Ashley, Kalakichi Nation, us to rise up and us go.
Well, that's just about it. AC, Elder Collytown, we got to get up out of here. We trust that you had a real good time today. Listen, if you're interested in joining our singles club, hit us up on Facebook, Arthur Chisholm. I'll be riding a white horse or Elder Collytown. Inbox either one of us. We'll hook you right up. If you're interested in joining the singles club, that's right, just inbox Arthur Chisholm or Elder Collytown with your contact information so we can contact you and get you an application. And then we can hurry up and get this thing started. Well, we can have a big party, an old school party. You'll get a chance to meet and greet all of the entertainers that have been on this show. Get you an old school girl, old school guy. Look at here, we just want to have some clean fun. Look at here, we're thinking about bringing some of the contestants on our show. We can't let you see them, but we let you hear the voice. We can't tell you who they are, but they can tell you what they're looking for. Look, get your application in right now. Inbox Arthur Chisholm or Elder Collytown. Old school party. Let's get it done, just like we used to do.
Old school girl, rocking my world. Old school girl. Now back in the days when our love was about peace and happiness, and all the brothers were about style and classiness, love was sure to stand the test of time, cause true commitment was a state of mind. Tell me, whatever happened to the feelings of emotions that lovers felt when they were pledging their devotion? Can we just go back? Can we turn back the hands of time? Yeah. You can keep your diamonds and pearls. I don't need those riches of the world. All I need is love, and I'll give the whole world just to spend one day with my old school girl. Just give me my old school lady, my old school.
Yeah, buddy, if you're ready to turn your life around, maybe you can get a ring on your finger and take you to the church and go to the altar. Come on here.